The International Monetary Fund says the Philippines still has room to introduce new tax measures that will create more fiscal space. That's as it sees fiscal consolidation proceeding in 2024, but more moderate than earlier projected. Let's continue our discussion on the Philippine taxation system with Ateneo de Manila University Economics Professor Leonardo Lanzona Jr. So first of all, sir, I'd like to ask you if you agree with the IMF's assessment of the Philippines fiscal policy that, you know, we have room and that we should in fact be raising more taxes.
Yeah, definitely. I would agree with the IMF, no? But given the fact that our budget has been increasing over the years, and the budget deficit has also had increased over time, so there's certainly a need for fiscal consolidation, and in this particular case, raising taxes would be the best way to solve this problem.
What kind of taxes can the government implement to minimize the impact on inflation and, you know, still allow them to raise enough revenues?
Well, definitely we shouldn't be putting too much, these so-called indirect taxes, because we've been heavily reliant on indirect taxes. Lately, there was a 12% increase in the use of digital service platforms. So if you look at the proportion of the indirect taxes to the total revenues of the government, it's already around 60%. So I would think that there should be more income taxes, wealth taxes, and also what the IMF was recommending, and that maybe we can impose some excise taxes on carbon in particular. We could increase our taxes in many different ways, but it's crucial that we also address the problem of structure to make it more progressive, so that we are not taxing the lower income classes.
One of the issues as far as Philippine taxation is concerned is that our tax rate is quite high, really. And you know, that is something that is being criticized for our inability to attract foreign direct investments. But that said, I guess the tax that collection efficiency is so low. I mean, what seems to be the problem? Because if your tax rates are so high anyway, why aren't they translating to more revenues?
I think the reason why the DOF secretary said that he will not raise taxes because he was afraid that it's going to impact on inflation. That's also one reason why we should not further increase indirect taxes. So if we put our taxes, let's say, on incomes, or let's say on profits, like capital gains tax, that will not have any impact on the marginal cost, the cost of the firms. And so there will be no effect on inflation. So the fear that it's going to lead to more inflation could easily be solved by putting in more lump sum taxes, particularly on the incomes of, I suppose, the millionaires and then, the corporations. So they're actually disproportionately putting more taxes on the lower income consumers. And then they're trying to protect much of these corporations, the wealthy individuals. So I think that's where we should really focus on. How do we make the taxes more progressive and at the same time be able to, achieve fiscal consolidation, try to reduce our budget deficits.
So you highlighted a while ago, for example, the capital gains taxes being you know, one type of tax that the government can impose, and this would you know, impact the richer rather than the poorer. Maybe you could give us some other examples of what type of taxes the government can do or what kind of reforms they can do as far as taxation is concerned so that, you know, it will be more progressive and it will tax the rich rather than the poor.
I was making some, back of the envelope computations. And if, let's say, if we tax all the millionaires by 25%, for instance, we will already be getting around 60 billion pesos. So that is close to the 80 billion, to the 80 billion pesos that we're charging on enough for the DSP. I mean, the expected revenues that you're supposed to be getting from the taxes from the DSP. So maybe just, imposing a wealth tax of maybe 25% on the billionaires that we have. That will give us a lot of revenues that will help solve our, budget deficit problems.
So would that be on, say, the income of these millionaires, or because I'm sure it's already being taxed right now around the same level.
Well, actually, they're saying that we should not tax them, no? I mean, it has always been proposed, and they're saying that if we tax this, if we impose wealth taxes, there's a likelihood that these billionaires will leave the country, and then move their investment in some other place. But you have to remember, most of these billionaires are really in real estate, so I don't know how they can move their assets to other countries. So, and also another thing, huh, about the IMF proposal. I mean, it's possible that taxes will raise prices or cause some inflation, but we also have to take care of our environment, right? So taxes are not just to increase revenues, but it's also intended to change behavior. So that's why we had a lot of sin taxes before, no? We wanted people to avoid cigarettes and alcohol. So maybe if we impose taxes on coal, for instance, while it might indeed cause probably some increases in the prices, I think in the long run it's actually good for the country, because now we need to find alternative sources of energy. And in that sense, solve our environmental problems.
Would you have suggestions on how the government can generate revenues on a sustainable basis without possibly imposing new taxes? Is that even possible? I without cutting back, of course, on much needed spending on infrastructure as well as social services.
As I said, no, it's not just tax revenues that we should be looking at, but how the whole tax structure. So it's crucial that we make it more progressive, since we are in fact over-reliant on indirect taxes, especially with the imposition of the DSP taxes. So I think the government should start thinking about how to raise capital gains taxes, how to finally impose wealth taxes. And I think that's the best way. I mean, there's no other option except, to borrow money from abroad, and that will further worsen our debt problems. And so it's not just it's not it isn't so much, raising as much revenues as we can, but making sure that it is really progressive, and that it's not going to affect the lower income households.
Finally, I'd like to get your thoughts on the Philippines' debt to GDP ratio. So I think one of the issues going on is like there are some countries with very high debt to GDP ratios, and for example, in the US, there are some economists that are saying that this is not sustainable. They can't bring it down, or there's a chance that they can't. But how do you feel about the Philippines? Are you also worried that we've reached a level that's too high, or is it still at a level that we can grow our ways out of the high level of debt to GDP?
Well, debt by itself is presumably not a problem if we're going to use the debt efficiently and productively. But usually for emerging countries like the Philippines, we really need to put it down. I mean, it sort of puts a country at a risk. Of course, countries like Japan, Korea, they could have maybe a
Very
debt to
high,
GDP
like
ratio of
100
maybe more
percent.
than 100%, right? But they're rich countries, so we can afford to do so. But in the case of the Philippines, we really need to be very careful, because people are not that confident as far as how we can manage the debt and so on. So we really need to be very prudent, and try to make sure that if ever we try to get more debt, that we really use it in the more efficient and more productive.
Like, what level of debt to GDP ratio would you be more comfortable with as far as the
I
Philippines is
think right now
concerned?
it's around 60%, right? But
Yeah.
if you look at the GDP, it's been growing. So if it's growing, the debt to GDP ratio should be declining. And yet it is sort of stuck at around 60%. So it would seem that if indeed the growth rate of the country is moving at 6%, maybe the debt is maybe even increasing by more than 6%. Just to keep that ratio. So there seems to be a problem in that case. I mean, it would seem that a lot of the growth that we have is really coming from our debts. Government taking control over so many different activities. And in the process, we might be crowding out the private sector. So I think we need to be very careful. And if it's a choice between debt and raising taxes, I would think raising taxes would be the best option.
Yeah, because
So,
our deficit is still high, I would think, because the government the budget still grows by around 10% per annum. And of course, with a higher debt level, your interest expenses go up as well. So it really is very challenging for the government. And as you said,
Although
maybe.
things seem to be looking up, no? I mean, inflation is now down. I think the government should take this opportunity now to stabilize our fiscal standing, our debt standing. Because if you look at, what's happening all over the world, there's a chance that inflation might come again, no? There might be a resurgence of inflation and all of these geopolitical tensions. It's making a lot of investors, quite worried about what's going to happen. So while things seem to be going very smoothly right now, I think it's the time when we should really put more reforms, especially in the tax structure.
Thank you very much for your thoughts on the government debt and deficit, Mr. Lanzona. Really appreciate your thoughts, and hopefully our debt levels in the country successfully go down as planned by the government. Thank you so much.